Let's wrap up this review of matrix theory by talking about what does the rank of a matrix actually tell us. See, if we have an M by N matrix, we often think of that as just a collection of vectors. We've got N vectors in Rm. And in fact, if you want to understand various properties of a collection of N vectors, the standard thing to do is turn them into a matrix, and then look at the rank of that matrix. So the first thing to note is that the rank can never be bigger than M, and it can never be bigger than N. After all, you can only have one pivot in a row. The pivot is the first non-zero entry. So you can't have more pivots than rows. You can't have more than one pivot in a column, because each pivot has to be to the right of the previous one. So you can't have more pivots than columns. Well, the next thing to note is, when are a bunch of vectors linearly independent? They're linearly independent if the only solution to Ax equals 0 is x equals 0. But that means that there are no free variables, so everything is a pivot variable, so you have a pivot in each column. They're linearly independent if and only if you have a pivot in each column, which is if and only if the rank is equal to n. Now, if there are more columns than rows, if you've got a short and fat matrix, then that's impossible because the rank is never bigger than M. So if you have short and fat matrix, they're not linearly independent. They are linearly dependent. So if you have 5 vectors in R4 or 17 vectors in R13 or more vectors in a smaller space, they're always linearly dependent. You can't cram more than 7 linearly independent vectors into R7. We learned about the span of vectors. The span of all of these vectors, which we call the column space, you wonder, does it equal all of Rm? If it equals all of Rm, we say that these vectors span Rm. Well, that'll happen if and only if there's a pivot in each row. Because if there's a pivot in each row, once you put it in reduced row echelon form, there are no contradictions. You can always solve the equations Ax equals B. But if there isn't a pivot in each row, then for some choices of B, there won't be any solutions. And so, pivot in each row means the rank equals M. And if you've got a tall and skinny matrix, if N is less than M, then there's no hope of spanning, because the rank can never be M, because it's never bigger than N. So if you have 3 vectors in R5, they can't span R5. There aren't enough of them. You need at least 5 vectors to span R5. You need at least 7 vectors to span R7. So this tells us that if you want a basis for, say, R7, it has to consist of exactly 7 vectors. If you have more than 7 vectors, they're linearly dependent. If you have fewer than 7 vectors, they don't span. If you have something that spans and is linearly independent, it's got to consist of exactly 7 vectors. Or for Rm, it has to consist of exactly m vectors. That's why we say the dimension of Rm is m. Finally, what happens if somebody does give you 7 vectors in R7? Well, you look at the rank. If the rank is n, then the rank is also equal to m. The rank is n, so they're linearly independent. The rank is m, so they span. So we've got a basis. If the rank is as big as it can be, which is n, you have a basis. If the rank is less than n, it's also less than m. It's less than n, so it's linearly dependent. It's less than m, so it doesn't span. So when you have the right number of vectors, either it's linearly independent and spans, or it's linearly dependent and doesn't span. Finally, a word on dimensions. The dimensions of the column space was the rank. And we had a basis made of the pivot columns. The dimension of the null space was n minus the rank, because we had a basis associated to the free variables. Every free variable gave you a different solution. The space of solutions is given by a bunch of vectors, one for each free variable. And if you add the two together, you always get exactly n. This is called the dimension theorem. No matter what matrix there is, no matter what the rank is, the size of the column space plus the size of the null space is the width of the matrix.